Good morning, Brother Perry. Lord bless you, brother. Good morning, Sister Onika. All right, we're coming from Guyana, live here. This is Brother Jeremiah next to me here. And we'll start our morning service here with a word of prayer. Let us pray. Father God, we come before you, Lord, today. We thank you, God, for your goodness. We thank you, Lord, for the liberty we have today in our world, oh God, to preach your gospel, to live for Jesus Christ. Father God, we ask your blessing this morning. In Jesus Christ's wonderful name, we pray and ask. Amen. We'll start out with, all to Jesus I surrender. Amen. All to Jesus I surrender. Surrender all.
Savior, I surrender all to Jesus.
Surrender all. Good morning, Brother Tankrell. Good morning, Sita. So good to see you all today watching. Amen. Thank you for joining us, worshiping together this morning. Draw me nearer.
Thou hast done, draw me nearer.
Samantha. So good to see you all this morning. Thank you for joining. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. We'll sing Love Lifted Me. When we think about that love, let us think about Jesus Christ. Amen.
I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore. Very deep stand within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea, by my despairing cry, from the waters lifted me, now safe from my love lifted me. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me. Love lifted me. Love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me.
All right, we'll continue the song. But the next time we read the chorus, instead we said love, we'll say Jesus lifted me. Amen. Think about Jesus. Lift Peter out of the waves. Amen. When he out of the water, when he was sinking. Amen. And Jesus can lift us this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. Jesus can lift us this morning. Out of our situation, praise the Lord.
My heart to Him I gave, ever to Him I cling. In His blessed presence live, ever His praises sing. Love so mighty and so true, merits my soul with song. Faithful love and service good to Him belong. Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, when nothing else could help. Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, when nothing else could help. Jesus lifted me. Souls in danger look about, Jesus completely saves. He will lift you by His love out of the angry waves. He's the master of the sea, billow His will obey. He is Savior, wants to be saved today. Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, when nothing else could help. Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, Jesus lifted me, when nothing else could help. Jesus lifted me.
Amen. Jesus lifting me. Amen. And this morning, He can lift you. Amen. He can lift you. Praise the Lord. Yes, He can lift you out of your situation. Whatever it might be, He can lift you out of those situations. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Our next song will be What a Fellowship, What a Joy Divine.
What a fellowship, what a joy divine. fancy girl from all around.
Today we want to hello Brother Don. Thank you for watching. Thank you for joining us this morning. Amen. All the way from Guyana, South America, this message is coming to you live from Guyana, South America. Guyana is the only English speaking country in South America. Amen. And is the northern part geographically, the northern part of South American continent, between Brazil, Venezuela, and Suriname. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, this morning I want to bring you a short message from the book of Mark, entitled "Go on a little farther for Jesus Christ." Go on a little farther for Jesus Christ. You know, sometime in life we tend to slow up because of the circumstances and situation or situations that arises. We tend to slow up, we tend to take a break. And some people even tend to quit and back out of the Christian life. But this morning, from Mark chapter 1, I want to bring you this message. Go on a little farther for Jesus Christ. Amen. The Bible says in Mark chapter 1 verse 1, the beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophets, behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John did baptize in the wilderness and preaching the gospel. Preaching the gospel John did baptize in the wilderness and preach the gospel. Preach a baptism of repentance for the remission of sins. And there went out unto him all the land of Judah, and they of Jerusalem, and were all baptized of him in the river of Jordan, confessing their sins. Amen. The Bible goes on to say here, and they went out unto him all the land of Judah, and they of Jerusalem were baptized of him in the river Jordan, confessing their sin. And John was clothed with camel hairs and with a girdle of a skin about his loins, and he did eat locusts and wild honey, and preached, saying, there cometh one mightier than I after me, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to stoop down and unloose. I indeed baptize you with water, but he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost. Amen. Praise the Lord. So there we see Jesus, John the Baptist, recognize Jesus Christ and so on. Amen. Praise the Lord. Just a moment, let me get my scripture here. The Bible goes on to say here in verse 16 of Mark chapter 1. Now as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew his brother casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And Jesus said unto them, come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men. And straightway they forsook their nets and followed him. And when he had gone a little farther thence, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, who also were in the ship mending their nets, and straightway he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the ship with their hired servants, and went after him. Mm-hmm. Amen. Praise the Lord. So the message this morning is go a little farther. Go on a little farther for Jesus Christ. And it's very short this morning. I don't want to keep you long there. Father God, we come before you, Lord, today. We ask your blessing, Lord God, on your word today. Bless those that watch live, Lord, and those who might watch later on, Lord. In Jesus Christ's name we pray and ask, Lord. Amen. Amen. So there we see Jesus Christ was baptized by John the Baptist. Amen. Right, Brother Jeremiah?
Amen.
And he was baptized there by John the Baptist and so forth. And then Jesus Christ was led by the Holy Spirit of God. Come pull a chair and join us, brother. He was led by the Holy Spirit of God to go into the wilderness there, and he fasted 40 days and 40 nights. He fasted and prayed and so forth. But as Jesus Christ exited the wilderness, you know, we must realize that Jesus Christ, though he was God in flesh, he was 100% human being. without sin. So yet Jesus Christ had feelings. At times Jesus Christ was hungry. At times Jesus Christ was thirst. This is Brother Leslie here with us. So at times he was hungry, he was thirst. I remember he cried, amen, at Lazarus' graveside and so forth. But as Jesus Christ exited the wilderness there after his fasting, his cousin John the Baptist was thrown into jail for preaching the gospel. Now, think about that. Jesus Christ heard the news that his cousin was thrown into jail for preaching the gospel. And this was the man that just baptized him. Now, we all know that John the Baptist, his time will not be long. His time is about to expire on earth. Yet he lives in eternity. But Jesus Christ, on the human side, he could have been discouraged and said, you know what? They throw my cousin in prison. Now let me quit. Or let me hide myself for a while. No, no, the Bible didn't say so. The Bible say, and it came to pass in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized of John here in Jordan. Let me jump down back here, miss my verse. The Bible said, now as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And Jesus said unto them, come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men.
Amen.
So Jesus Christ, he got himself two disciples there. He got himself Simon, Peter, and Andrew. It was a long day. Jesus Christ could have quit. But no, Jesus Christ did not quit. Because you know that there is still opportunity to win more to himself. The Bible says, straightway they forsook their nets and followed him. But here the Bible say, and as he gone a little farther thence, he saw James, the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, who also were in the ship mending their nets. Amen. So there he saw these two other brothers here. Amen. Mending their father nets and so on. And Jesus told them to follow him. So he went a little farther. And he got some results. You know, sometime in our life, you know, we need to go a little farther, even though we don't see the results. We might not see the results on earth here, but God is the one that keep the books and keep the records good.
Amen.
Because he's the one that have the record, and we might not see the results this hour, in these days and time, but God keep the records.
Amen.
Now, amen. Now, he went a little farther here. James, we know that James, he wrote the book of James and about faith and so on. He's the son of Zebedee and so forth. Amen. And John, here is called John the Beloved. John wrote the epistle, the gospel of John, 1st and 2nd and 3rd John. And he received the revelation of Jesus Christ on the Isle of Patmos. Had not Jesus went a little farther, we wouldn't have the book of James. We wouldn't have the book of 1st and 2nd and 3rd John.
on the Gospel of John in the life of Christ, and we wouldn't have the revelation. Think about that. Now, in the present time, we might not see the result when we are weary, when we are tired, when we hear bad news that our cousin is thrown in prison for preaching the gospel and to take a stand for righteousness. But many years after, we have the books today. We have the revelation of Jesus Christ about past, present, and future events.
Amen. Amen.
And we have the 1st and 2nd and 3rd John, the letters of the New Testament about love and how to fellowship. Amen. And then we have the book of John about the love of God.
Amen.
Now we are to go a little farther because hell is a real place.
Right.
We are to go a little farther because souls are dying and going to hell.
Right.
And God needs someone to take a stand that will love these souls and be a witness and go the extra mile like Jesus did.
Amen.
For James and John. Amen. He already had Andrew and Peter, but he decided to go a little farther than. Let us do not get comfortable. Let us come out of our comfort zone.
Amen.
At times and do something for God. After all, God saved us to serve Him.
Amen.
He saved us to serve Him.
That's right.
Paul commanded us in Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. Paul said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable, which is a reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is God good and perfect and acceptable will of God. God wants us to present our bodies a living sacrifice.
Amen. That's right.
Amen. Now, folks, I want to leave four things with you, and then my dear preacher friend, Brother Leslie, will bring another message here. But we ought to go a little farther in these four aspects. Number one, in our time.
Amen.
The Bible said to everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven in Ecclesiastes chapter 3. God desired to have our time. Time is important in the work of God.
Amen.
Don't consume all your time to benefit your earthly life.
Good stuff.
But give time back to the Lord. Give time to read the Word of God. Give time to study. Give time to visit. Amen. The lost and win them. The job is not for the pastor and the leaders alone of the church.
Amen.
The job is for every Christian. Every person. Every Christian ought to take hold on the gospel and share it, propel it.
Amen.
Share it so souls can get saved. Now, we ought to go a little farther in our time. Then secondly, in our talent.
Amen.
What is our talent? Our talent is the godly idea that God give us to be creative in our Christian life. Whether singing, preaching, witnessing, whatever it might be, whatever talent God give you, use it for His honor and glory to draw others to His kingdom.
Amen.
Then we ought to go a little farther in our time, in our talent, but in our temple, in our body. This body, God will use it. The psalmist said, that when he is in the grave, his body cannot do anything for God.
That's right.
And folks, we have this body. God give it to us. Let us use it to worship Him, to praise Him, to glorify Him, to magnify Him. The Apostle Paul said that we are living letters, living epistles, meaning living letters. Amen. We are living letters. That means our body sent a message to the world. Let us use, let us give, go a little farther in our time, talent, temple. Lastly, in our treasure. Jesus Christ said, where your treasure is, there will your heart also be. So many people are not given what belongs to God, to God house.
That's right, come on.
God give us, we should give back. There were times that you were out of job. You didn't have a job. You didn't have a business or anything like that. And God desire for you to work and give unto God.
Amen.
Amen. I want to thank you for listening this morning and so forth. I know I'll have Brother Leslie come and bring a message on Exchange City. But before now, we'll sing a song. Amen. Time, Brother Leslie will bring a message.
Hi, good morning to all those who are watching. Thank you very much, Pastor Ram, for the opportunity. My name is Leslie Patrick Finance, and it's a privilege that I have to share the Word of God with all those that are watching and listening. Amen. Today, my text is taken from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 5, verse 17 to verse 26. It says there in the Luke chapter 5, verse 16, it says, let me start on 17. And it came to pass on a certain day, as he was teaching, that there were Pharisees and doctors of the law sitting by, which were come out of every tongue of Galilee and Judea and Jerusalem. And the power of God, of the Lord, was present to heal them. 18. And behold, men brought in a bed, a man which was taken with a palsy, and they sought means to bring him in, and to lay him before Jesus, And when they could not find by what way they might bring him in because of the multitude, they went and let him down through the tiling with his couch into the midst before Jesus. And when he saw their faith, he said unto him, Man, thy sins are forgiven thee. And the scribes and the Pharisees began to reason, saying, Who is this which speaketh blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God alone? But when Jesus perceived their thoughts, he answering said unto them, What reason ye in your hearts? Whether is easier to say, Thy sins be forgiven thee, or to say, Rise up and walk? But that ye may know that the Son of Man had power upon earth to forgive sins. And he said unto the sick of the palsy, I say unto thee, Arise, take up thy couch, and go into thy house. And immediately he rose up before them, and took up that whereon he lay, and departed to his own house, glorifying God. Let's pray this morning. Father in heaven, dear Lord, we thank you, God, for being such a wonderful God toward us. Thank you for your love, God. Thank you for the privilege that we have, that we can, God, share your word. And to God, thank you for the privilege that we have, Lord, and the honor, Lord, that we have in our country, God, to serve you freely, God. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for making it so free and simple for us, God. And thank you, Lord, for this time. Father, I pray that you help me to be a blessing to many, God. Father, speak to the hearts of many that are listening, and that many that will look at this video, or many that are looking right now, God. I pray, if they're not saved, I pray for salvation today, God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Now, the Bible tells us here that one day Jesus was preaching and in a house, and some men saw that there was a man had a need. You know, this man was sick, taken with palsy. This man was paralyzed and he was on his bed. And the Bible tells us that these men, the Bible did not mention their name or where they came from, but the Bible said that these men saw that this man who was taken with this palsy had a great need. And the Bible says that they took this man and they said, you know what, we're going to take him to Jesus. Probably they saw Jesus did miracles before, or they heard about him. I don't know. But you know what? The Bible says that these men saw that this man that was lying there had a great need.
Amen.
And the Bible says that they took up this man with his bed or his couch, and they sought means to take him to lay him before Jesus. And the Bible says that because of the multitude that was there, they could not enter into the building or the house where Jesus was. So they went on top of the house and they removed the tilings. And the Bible says that they let him down before Jesus. And the Bible says when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the man that was sick with palsy, he said, Man, thy sins are forgiven thee. Folks, I want to preach on quickly this morning. Mankind, what is mankind's greatest need? Amen. Mankind's greatest need is not to get rich. Mankind's greatest need is not to be delivered or be recovered from COVID-19 or whatever the pandemic is. Mankind's greatest need is not to be healed from a sickness that is affecting them. Mankind's greatest need is not to be delivered from demonic. And I am for people getting healed. I am for people recovering from sickness. I am for miracles in life. I am for people achieving things. Amen?
Amen.
But what I want to focus on is that our greatest need is not these things of the world. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
God knows our greatest need.
Amen.
There is a greater need than achieving things, folks. There is a greater need than being delivered from demonic possession. There is a greater need than to recover from sicknesses. Amen? And God knows our greatest need. Do you know, folks, many have been delivered from demonic possession and they bust hell wide open when they die? Do you know many receive great riches of this world and when they die, they bust hell wide open? Do you know many have been delivered from sickness and still die and go straight to a burning hell?
Yeah.
Why? Because they believe that being delivered from the sickness or their possession or their poverty, believing that that they have achieved some great thing in life from God. But the greatest thing, folks, we need is that our soul, our sins need to be forgiven.
Amen.
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 And God knows our greatest need. Imagine that man and his friends with the anticipation waiting to see or to hear Jesus said, "Hey, you're healed. Take up your bed and walk." But instead, Jesus said to this man, "Hey, man, thy sins are forgiven thee." You can imagine the impression upon those men's face or how they felt inside, believing that Jesus would have said, "Hey, take up your bed and walk." Amen? You see, folks, the Bible tells us, it says, "For what shall it profit a man if he gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul?" Folks, what shall it profit you if you gain the world, the world's riches, and lose your own soul? What shall it profit you if you've been delivered from demonic possession and your sins are not forgiven? Amen?
Amen.
Folks, we have a greater need. And our need is for our sins need to be forgiven. Amen? And God knows that. Folks, if you die in your sin, without your sins being forgiven, the Bible tells us that you will die and go to a burning hell. Amen?
Amen.
And there is no coming back from there. Being delivered from a sickness does not mean that your sins are forgiven. Achieving this world's riches does not mean that your sins are forgiven. Amen? Folks, God is a God that hears and answers prayers, and He will reward you for calling upon Him and trusting Him and believing that what the Bible says that is true. But folks, if you never trust Jesus and ask Him to forgive you your sins, you will die and go to a burning hell. Amen? God knows our greatest need.
Yeah.
Amen? The Bible tells us there in Luke chapter 5 verse 18. It says, "And behold, men brought in a man which was taken with a palsy, and they sought means to bring him in and to lay him before him." Now, "And when they could not find by what way they might bring him in because of the multitude, they went upon the housetop and let him down through the tiling." Now, folks, hear this. Now, These men look at this friend here, or whoever it was to them, and they saw that this man, you know what? We're going to help this man. We're going to help meet his needs. And we believe to ourselves that the greatest need right now is for this man to walk again. Amen. And they say, you know what, to themselves, hey, we're going to help this man here. We're going to help him. We're going to take him, take up his couch, or we're going to take him as he is, and we're going to believing to themselves. Thank you, Pastor. Hey, we're fulfilling the greatest need in this man's life. Folks, you see, as human beings, we can only see the outer part and our physical needs. We may believe, we may believe that by giving something to someone that is in a great need, you know, we are helping this person in a great way. And the truth is that, you know, it is good to be a blessing to people, amen? It's good to help out people. But you know what? There are people out there who are lost, and if they die in their sins, they will bust hell wide open. Those people have a greater need. Amen?
Amen.
Though that doctors may labor to save someone that is affected with the COVID-19 or even other sicknesses, but you know what? Doctors cannot save their soul from a burning hell. Amen?
Amen.
Providing a little food or some food stuff for someone, providing a need for them, does not mean that their soul or their sins are been forgiven. Amen?
Amen.
Folks, men or mankind see that there is a need in people's life, in one's life, and they try their best to help them. But just to remind you that this world and the lost have a greater need. Amen? And that need is for their sins to be forgiven. Amen? Amen. And God knows that. The Bible says that God looked at this man and said, hey, thy sins are forgiven thee, folks. Let me ask you this question quickly. Is your sins forgiven? Have you ever trusted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Is there a time in your life that you can acknowledge or remember the day and the time that you have trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? And trust in Him alone to take you to heaven. If you have never trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, folks, no matter whatever it is in this world that you have achieved or been delivered from, and you never trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, well then, your greatest need has yet still need to meet. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Folks, I want to tell you this. God did make a way for us that our sins can be forgiven. Amen? That our greatest need can be met. Amen? The Bible tells us in John 3:16, it says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Bible tells us in verse 17, for God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. Amen. Folks, God loved us so much. He gave His Son for us so that through Him our sins can be forgiven. Amen.
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 Folks, this world has a need. Still today, and God saw it many years. God saw that this world had a need, and He sent His Son so that through Him that need can be met. Amen?
Amen.
Folks, I want to tell you a couple of things quickly. God loves you so much. He doesn't want us to die and go. He doesn't want you to die and go to a burning hell. God make a way for us. And that way is through His Son. Amen. In Romans 3:10, it says, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." It says in Romans 3:23, it says, Romans 3:23, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Folks, we are all sinners. And because we are sinners, we come short of the glory of God. But how do we come short of the glory of God? The Bible says in Romans 5:12, "Wherefore, as by one man sin enter into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned." When Adam sinned against God, that is how sin entered into the world. And we have all inherited a sinful nature from Adam. And because of that sinful nature that we have inherited, caused us to break God's law.
Amen.
Amen. So folks, none of us, we are not perfect. We are all sinners and we come short of that holiness and pureness. Amen. Folks, many believe today that they are righteous. Many believe today that, oh, Brother Patrick or Pastor Ram, you know what? We never do anything wrong. We have a clean heart.
Man.
You know, we always treat people nice. We have a kind heart. We have a good heart. But the truth is, folks, the Bible says, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." Amen? All, not some. Many believe by keeping the law and the Ten Commandments, they never curse, they never steal. But folks, the Bible says, if you break one, it means that you break all.
Amen.
Amen. So no one has been able to keep the whole law.
Amen.
So, the Bible tells us, folks, if you break one, for whosoever shall keep the whole law, and yet offended at one point, he is guilty of all. But I just tell one little lie, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
It's just one little lie. But that one little lie make you break the whole law. Mm. Amen?
Amen.
Folks, nobody has been able to keep the whole law.
Amen.
Bible says, and because of that, we break God's law. And the penalty for that, for breaking God's law, the Bible says, for sin is a transgression of the law.
Amen.
And the Bible says, for the wages of sin is death.
Amen.
Folks, so you see, if you die in your sin, your payment for your sin is death. Separation from God in hell. Let me ask you this here. What is it that you believe you need to do to go to heaven, folks? For the wages of sin is death. But you know what? God loves us so much. He doesn't want us, or He doesn't want this world, this sinful world, to die and go to a burning hell. He make a way for us. Amen. The Bible says, like I repeat here in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son." God loved us so much. He gave His Son so that through Him, our sins can be forgiven and we can have a quality time with God in heaven when we die. Amen.
Amen.
God loved us so much. He doesn't want us to die and go to a burning hell. The Bible tells us in Romans 5:8, "But God commended His love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." Amen. God loves us, and He make a way for us. And that way is through His Son.
Yeah.
Bible says in John chapter 14, verse 6, "And Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me." God make a way for us. Amen.
Amen.
And that way is through Jesus Christ.
He is the only way, folks, that our sins can be forgiven and we can have a home in heaven.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible tells us in John chapter 10 verse 9, it says, and Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved. Amen.
Amen.
I am. Not I and these things are the way, Pastor. Mm-hmm. Not I and live a good life, brother. Not I and go to church. Not I and being delivered. Not I and my money, Pastor. Mm-hmm. I alone. I am the only way. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the only way to heaven, folks. There is only one way, and that way is through Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Folks, the Bible tells us that salvation, eternal life, it's a free gift. We don't have to do any work for it. It's a gift. Bible says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. It's a gift, Pastor. We don't have to work our way to go to heaven. Jesus Christ did all the work already. All we have to do is receive that precious gift. Amen. Through Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
He is the only way, folks. God has made a way so that our greatest need can be fulfilled. Amen? But do you know the world and many who don't understand this look at it as a joke? Folks, many believe that they will work to inherit a lot of things and to achieve a lot of things, but when they're ready, then they will give their life to God. Amen. Then they will give their lives and say, God, take me now. I achieve all these things in my life. But little that this world don't know, or many don't understand, is that we're not promised tomorrow. None of us are promised tomorrow. Bible says, boast not that we don't know what a day may bring forth. Folks, if you die in your sin, you will die and go to a burning hell. But God has made a way for us. And that way is through Jesus Christ. He is the only way. There is no other way. Amen. Bible says Amen. That the gift of God is eternal life. How does a gift become yours if someone gives it to you? You have to receive it. The Bible says in Ephesians 2:8-9, for by grace are we saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it's a gift of God. Amen.
Amen.
Not of works, but it's a gift. You have to do work for a gift, well then it's a payment. It's not a gift anymore. Bible says, but as many as receive him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God.
Amen.
You need to receive Jesus Christ. Where do you need to receive him? Into your heart. Amen. And how do you receive him? Bible says, in Romans 10:9, Bible tells us in Romans 10:9, it says, that if thou shalt confess with the mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Bible says, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, folks.
Amen.
Not by your works, not by being delivered, not by being rich, not by achieving things, but by Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Believing in your heart and confessing with your mouth. Not by your works, folks. Amen.
Amen.
Not by your works. Let me ask you this. Pastor, let me say that you had loved your wife. And you never tell her that you love her. You didn't make a verbal confession or profession that, hey, I love you. Would that make sense to you?
No.
To her?
No.
No, that wouldn't make no sense. And had she gone and married somebody else, you would be the loser, isn't that so? Amen?
Yeah.
But, folks, likewise, the Bible says that we need to confess. We need to make a verbal confession of what we believe in our heart. Amen?
Amen.
We need to make that verbal confession, folks, from the depths of our heart, with all our might, all our strength, all our understanding. We need to confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Folks, only through Jesus Christ that your sins can be forgiven. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
There is no other way. There is one way, and that way is through Jesus Christ.
Amen. Yeah.
So folks, if you have never trusted Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, and you are dying in your sin, your greatest need has never been met. Mm. You will die and go straight to a burning hell.
Yeah.
Folks, like I said, our greatest need is we need that our sins need to be forgiven.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, folks? I ask you today to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And how, say Brother Patrick, how do I do that? You need to confess that Jesus Christ did came. You need to believe in your heart that he came and died, that he was buried, and that he rose the third day for Amen. Your sins. You need to believe with all your heart and confess with your mouth. Amen. And the Bible says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Amen.
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 Folks, when you have accepted Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, your greatest need has just been met.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Everything else come after, folks. Had I died earlier before I get saved, I would have gone straight to a burning hell.
Mm. Yeah.
Had Pastor died before he got saved, he would have gone straight to a burning hell. Yeah. And I'm telling you this here, in time past, before I got saved, I've been delivered from a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Mm. I've been delivered from a lot of situations. I've been delivered from a lot of, you know, a lot of things in life, folks.
Yeah.
But though I have been delivered and I have achieved things in time past, had I died then, I would have gone straight to a burning hell.
Mm.
Folks, many are calling upon God, and God is rewarding them because of his faithfulness to his word. Amen?
Amen.
But receiving things in prayer, folks, does not mean that you're saved.
Mm.
Amen? Amen? There is so much power in the name of Jesus Christ that demons tremble.
Yeah.
There is so much power in the name of Jesus Christ that people have been delivered and healed, Pastor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But they don't know the way to heaven.
That's like a 9-11. Amen.
They will die and go to a burning hell if they don't realize that their greatest need is that their sin needs to be forgiven.
Amen.
Amen. Folks, you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I ask you today that you get to know him. Amen?
Amen.
Let me just tell you this here. Preaching a great sermon does not make heaven rejoice. Amen? Achieving things in life doesn't make heaven rejoice. Amen? What make heaven rejoice is when one sinner repent.
Yeah.
Amen? Yeah. The whole heaven rejoice. Can you be that someone today that make heaven rejoice? By acknowledging your greatest need is that your sin needs to be forgiven. Amen?
Hmm.
If you have understand that the points that I have laid out, that you are a sinner, and that Your penalty for sin is hell. You have understand that Jesus Christ came and died for your sin. And that he is the only way to heaven. There is no other way to heaven. You believe that he came and died, and that he was buried, that he rose again the third day to take your sins away. You believe with all your heart. And it's good to believe, but you know what? You need to make that confession today.
Yeah.
Amen? Say, Brother Patrick, that is me. I'm ready to make that confession today. Folks, I'm willing to lead you in a prayer. But this prayer cannot save you. Only Jesus Christ can save you. But this prayer is allowing you to confess what you believe in your heart. Amen? And you're going to say this prayer, but don't say it to me. You're going to say it to God. Because only he can save you. Amen? Sincerely mean this prayer from all your heart. Believing that God came and died for your sin, and that only through him your sins can be forgiven. You're watching. You're listening. And you know that your sins are not forgiven. You know, you don't know if you were to die, where would you spend all eternity? Would you mind please bowing your heads and pray with me, please? Just repeat after me. Remember I said, this prayer cannot save you. Amen? But you confess in what you believe in your heart. Bible says, when you accept Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit comes into your heart and dwells there forever. He said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Amen? Bible says, but as many as receive him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. I don't believe no father would disown their child. And even if they do, that will never stop them from being their child. Amen? So let's bow our heads. Ready? Say, Lord Jesus, dear Lord, I know that I'm a sinner and I deserve to die and go to hell. But Lord, I believe that you came and died, that you was buried, and that you rose again the third day to take my sins away. Lord Jesus, I repent of my sins. Please come into my heart and save me. And I'm trusting you alone, Lord, to take me to heaven when I die. Lord Jesus, I now make you my Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. Folks, you understand that? If you have just said that prayer, sincerely meaning from all your heart, I believe, according to the Word of God, you are a born-again child of God. Amen?
Amen.
You stay in touch with Pastor Ram, and you can give him updates about how you're getting along and so forth. Amen? I will hand you over back to Pastor Ram. Thank you very much.
Amen. Praise the Lord for Brother Leslie. Brother Leslie is the evangelist out of our church. Preacher, pulpit filler, and everything else. Amen. God has called him in the ministry to preach his word. And let us know if you accept the Lord as your Savior out there. We'll sing a hymn, Standing on the Promises of God.
Amen.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his presence ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing, standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises that cannot fail, when the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing. the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises I cannot fall. Listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, thank you for watching, folks, and may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause His face to shine on you.
Amen.
We thank you. See you next time. Amen.